Hi, good morning everybody. Welcome to another beautiful Fast Friday, April 8th, 2022. And you're closer and closer to the big 4-1. But today is episode 683, I believe. I know yesterday's video, I said I quoted the wrong number in one of the videos yesterday, but when I did the editing, it was all, the number was right where it's supposed to be, so. But today, I believe it's 683, so this is part one, your Days of Praise passage, and we're going to be talking about boldness in the holy place, beginning with Hebrews 10:19. And this one is put together by Henry M. Morris once again. That's one of the main contributors to this, to the Days of Praise book, is Henry M. Morris, M-O-R-R-I-S, Morris. And then you have the Henry M. Morris III, John D. Morris, and then other, from book to book they change with guests. Contributors, but the Morris brothers and whatever they are, to get fathers and sons and stuff like that, they're pretty well the main contributors for the Morris. But if you're excited about this, we'll smash the like button. Comment, your first 7 days of April went. If you're excited about this, we'll smash the like button. So, I'm sorry about saying that, but subscribe if you're new, turn on notifications, share the video and channel with your family and friends, and help me reach that 100 subscriber mark by April the 18th, which is now 10 days away. 10 short days, and I'll be 41. But. And then once again, the countdown continues for the Easter week festivities. 2 days until pre-dress rehearsal on Sunday evening. Five days until dress rehearsal. Dress rehearsal is where we have to do the program all the way through dressed up with no audience. And then it is 6 days until night one. We got 1 week until night two, 7 days, 8 days until night three, 9 days till Easter, and 10 days until my birthday. That's the countdown for every single thing this week that I'm going to have to go through. So I'm asking prayers, everybody. Prayers for me and my fellow church members, church family members that are involved with this program. May we get everything in line, ready to go for Thursday night, the main program. And may it go off without a hitch. Pray for me Wednesday, because I'm gonna have to go traveling up to Gainesville, because my dad's got a doctor's appointment at the VA hospital. His appointment's at 1:00, and I've heard that the dress rehearsal is supposed to start about 5-6 o'clock. But I'm probably going to be running a little late. I'm going to try to go up early to the appointment. Maybe they can take him in earlier. And then get out and come home. So I can hopefully bring him home. He thinks he's going to go up there and stay up there. And me come back by myself. I don't think so. About a long way to go by myself. But if it does... It does, and I don't have to deal with it. But all I gotta do is get on the interstate and come back down the Wildwood, get off, come back down, hit the road around to the church, and I'll be there. But I'll have to tell them I'm going to be late. But let's get off that subject. A boldness in the holy place. Today's part one, Daily Devo, your Days of Praise passage. Starting with Hebrews 10:19, says, "Having therefore, brethren, boldness to enter into the holiest by the blood of Jesus." So in the ancient tabernacle, only the high priest was allowed to enter the Holy of Holies to commune with God, and that was only once a year on the great day of atonement. Oh, excuse me, sorry about that. This most holy place was separated from the rest by a very heavy veil. And when Christ died, however, as the one final and perfect sacrifice, the veil of the temple was rent in two, or it says twain, which would mean ripped in two pieces from the top to the bottom, Matthew 27:51. And this rent in twain, T-W-A-I-N. I've never seen the verse put like that. All I know is it's ripped in two. It was ripped. I don't know whether I got something I can. Okay. Okay, you see this little card here? It's an old, just advertisement to something. But you see how this here? You see how the line down this right here? That picture. The veil was ripped just like that. Ripped in two. I ain't worried about it. It was just an advertisement from Word of Life. I'm not worried about that. It wasn't important. So. But it was ripped. The veil was ripped in two. So the miraculous rendering of the veil was intended by the Lord to symbolize the wonderful truth that we now have open access to come into the very presence of God. Hebrews 10:20, the next verse after our beginning verse, says, By a new and living way, which he hath consecrated for us through the veil, that is to say, his flesh. So thus, as our verse, our beginning passage says, we no longer must go by way of priests and sacrifices to come to God. We can enter directly into the holiest by the blood of Jesus. So because of what Christ has done for us, we can come boldly, not arrogantly or presumptuously, however, into God's presence in prayer. Hebrews 4:15-16 says, "For we have not a high priest which cannot be touched with the feeling of our infirmities, but was in all points tempted like as we are, yet without sin. Let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need." Amen? So we can also have confidence, and it's the same Greek word as for boldness, in witnessing for Christ. So after praying for boldness, Acts 4:33, "With great power gave the apostles witness of the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all." So you might be hearing different things leading up to Easter time, which is the time of resurrection. So in the Holy Week thing, Thursday was Bloody Thursday. Friday was Good Friday, and I believe Saturday was Black Saturday. I'm not too sure about that, but on that one. And then Easter Sunday, as we all celebrate it, Easter is resurrection. It's the Lord's Day. It's Resurrection Sunday. basically. That's what we call it. That's what we usually call it every year at my church. Resurrection Sunday. He is risen, risen indeed. That's the phrase we use every year. I love that phrase, and it's probably going to be I'm probably going to use it too on the videos. When I do the Easter video, I will use that phrase, so be looking for that one. But just as did the apostles, in Christ we now have boldness and access with confidence by the faith of Him. Ephesians 3:12. Amen? So that's all I have for you today. Sorry for going over a little bit over my projected time. I usually try to do my videos within 10 minutes, but here lately I've been going out. But coming up tomorrow in your Jubilant Saturday, April the 9th, in part one of tomorrow's Daily Devo, I'm not even going to worry about saying the numbers until I get to doing the editing, and the numbers will go in there. So we're going to be learning about without the shedding of blood, Hebrews 9:22. So we're still in the book of Hebrews again. And that one's done from Henry Morris as well. But stay tuned to that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that tomorrow. Coming up at 1 o'clock today, we're going to be talking about part 2 of today's Daily Devo and our Daily Bread passage, Permanent Address, from Kirsten Holmberg, derived from Psalms 27:1-6. So stay tuned for that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that after 1. So with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe in all you say and do in 2022. And until later, peace out, everybody. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your beautiful Fast Friday morning, and come back again after 1 for Permanent Address. And we'll learn what that's gonna teach us. So until then, goodbye.